Have you ever wondered how we measure distances on Earth's surface? It's actually a very fascinating topic. There are different methods that we can use depending on what we are trying to measure and how accurate our measurements needs to be. Hi there, if you are a surveyor, then this video is for you. First off, there is grid distance, which is simply the distance between the two points on a UTM grid system. This method is often used in maps and plans, but it doesn't take into account the actual shape of the Earth. If we want to be more precise, then we can use geoidal distance, which takes into account the Earth's irregular shape by measuring distances along the surface of the Earth on a hypothetical sea level distance, which is also known as geoid. This method is often used in geodesy and surveying. And there is spheroidal distance, which is mathematically the most accurate distance measurement as it is measured on an ellipsoid. But this may not be as accurate as on the actual ground, as the spheroid is a smooth surface. Another method is rhomb line, which is a line that crosses all the meridians of the longitude at the same angle. This method is often used in ship's navigation as it is easier to point the direction of your ship at one angle and keep sailing till you reach your destination or not. We also have something called a geodesic distance, which is the shortest distance between two points on Earth's surface, taking into account of the Earth's curvature. This method is often used in aviation, satellite navigation, and geodesy. Now, all these methods use some pretty complicated mathematical formulas, which can be a bit intimidating. But the good news is that we have softwares and tools by which we can calculate the distances. Let us take the example of distances between Mumbai and Mexico City using various different methods. If you look up in the Google map, you will see some weird things are happening. Both the cities are on the same latitude, and when you measure them on a flat map, you see the distance to be 15,690 km. But the distance measurement line takes you via Greenland. Weird, eh? So when you actually switch to globe view, you see that the shortest distance between Mumbai and Mexico City is indeed via Greenland. Now, in grid distance method, distances are on a straight line, completely ignoring the curvature of the Earth. Using some basic math, we can find that the distance between Mumbai and the Mexico City is roughly around 14,000 km. Now, geodesic distance takes account of the curvature of the Earth and calculates the distance along the shortest path between the two points. The geodesic distance between Mumbai and Mexico City is around 14,280 km. Moving on to geoidal method, which takes into account the Earth's shape and the gravity field. Estimated geoidal distance between Mumbai and Mexico City is 14,120 km. Finally, we have rhomb line method. Estimated rhomb line distance between Mumbai and Mexico City is about 15,700 km. Of course, we are ignoring the fact that there could be any landmass between the two cities. Now, depending on the method you use to calculate the distance between two points, they could vary a few thousand kilometers. It's amazing to think about all the factors that goes in calculating distance on the Earth's surface. Let us now look at some of the formula that we can use to calculate distance. These formulas can be very tricky and complex. You can use Microsoft Excel if you want to practice, but you need to convert all the latitude longitude degrees into radians. For example, 360 degree equivalent to 2 pi radians, or 1 degree is equivalent to pi by 180 radians. To calculate the grid distance between two points, the Haversen formula is normally used. It is now on your screen. You can pause the video to note the formula.
If the eastern and northern coordinates are known for the two points, then you can use a Pythagorean theorem to find the straight distance between the two points on a 2D flat map. And here is the formula for them. Now here the K0 is the scale factor, which depends on the latitude of the points and where the position is in UTM grid zone. If you want to know more about the scale factor, then you should see this video.
Let's now calculate the geoidal distance between the two points based on their easting and northing. So the geoidal distance is grid distance minus geoid height of the first point plus the geoid height of the second point. By subtracting the geoid heights of both the points, it accounts for the effect of the gravity field between the two points. This correction is very important for accurate measurement in precise surveying like geodetic surveying. If you want to know more about the geoids, then you should see this video first. Now, as I said earlier, spheroidal distance is the distance between the two points on an ellipsoid. Now, this method can be very useful for small scale calculation where the Earth's surface can be taken as a smooth and continuous surface. Here is the formula on your screen. Please pause the video. Please note that this formula assumes that the Earth is an oblate spheroid. The formula to calculate the rum line distance between the two points is R multiplied by difference in latitude multiplied by 1 upon cos theta, where R is the radius of the Earth and theta is the constant angle between the rum line and the meridians at the starting point. The most commonly used geodesic distance formula is Vicentri formula. This formula takes into account the irregularities and the unevenness of the Earth's surface and provides a more accurate measurement of the actual distances between the two points. The formula is on your screen. If you are still watching at this point, please let me know by typing arctan in the comments below. I appreciate. Don't let this big formula scare you. As a surveyor, it is your job to understand the basics and do the mathematics correctly. I hope this video has helped you in understanding how we measure distances on the surface of the Earth. If you are interested, there are plenty of resources available online. I'll put some of the links of these resources in the description down below. Thanks for tuning in and happy exploring.